Groups of Oneidas migrated from New York to what would become the state of Wisconsin and brought with them the tradition of corn husk dolls. In Oneida culture, these faceless dolls traditionally symbolize humility and teach responsibility. Back at the Roadshow, another Native American item made for children turned up in front of our cameras. Take a look.
My father traded the service to the Winnebagoes who lived next to us, and we traded the service. They gave them this. They worked on our farm. They lived around us. We went to their powwows when I was younger. We were closely knit little community, a rural community.
Okay.
But we have equipment there. He must have fixed something for them.
He must have done something that was very much appreciated, because this is a significant object. It's quite interesting. Can you tell us when it came into your possession?
My understanding of it was the late 50s, early 60s.
So you've had it 60, 65 years.
It's been around the family.
Winnebago, you thought?
That's who gave it to us.
Okay. It's actually Cheyenne. Cheyenne Indians from the Great Plains. They're really well known for their decorated cradle boards. And this cradle board is gigantic.
It is.
I measured it. It's roughly 4.5 feet. It's really big. These are called skis. They're typically decorated with brass tacks. In this case, they're steel. And that's an indication that maybe it's a little bit later than the height of this tradition. The most famous of these and the most fully developed, maybe in more or less in the 1870s.
Oh.
My sense of this is it's a little bit later, 1890, possibly as late as 1900. The beadwork is classic Cheyenne design. In 1870, these beads would have been stitched with sinew, animal sinew.
Yep.
And these are stitched with cotton thread. There are elements of native tanned hide, but most of the backing and most of the foundation is canvas. So that would be a trade item rather than deer hide from an earlier period. But the designs are classic Cheyenne. They're carried over from the mid-19th century to the end of the century. So the lady who made this is very much honoring ancient traditions, ancient design symbols. This is meant to protect the baby.
Yes.
So this big hood, which could come all the way up like this, would protect the child from sunlight. If it fell, this would catch the ground and protect the head. It's a little bit tired in terms of condition. The cotton string is broken down a little bit. Some of the beads are missing. It's a little bit dirty. It's a little stiff in spots. All of that can be remedied. These are very desirable. It's a little bit late. It needs a little bit of help. But I think on a retail basis today,